Hello, you got Mr.
and Mrs.
Smith, the debt-free couple.
And you're my econ expansion leaders, EVP Infinity CEOs, located in North Little Rock, Arkansas.
Now, why is that important? Well, your number one asset has a lot to do with where you're currently located. We're in North Little Rock, Arkansas, currently streaming to you live from the Lehman Library for those of you who are in this area and know exactly where that is. But we want to talk to you about your number one asset. I know it's a lot of people who tell you what a great investment is. You should put your money here, put your money there. They can get you the best rate of return. But I promise you, if you weigh it all out, this is your number one asset. And we can prove it to you numerically. Women lie, men lie. Numbers don't. So let's dive in. As you can see, your number one asset consists of a total of different things. And when we say your number one asset, what we're talking about is a business. If you have a home-based business, guess what? You get to write off things that you might already be spending money on. As you can see in the list, you see mortgage, utility, cell phone, mileage, meals and entertainment, internet, things that you're already spending money on associated with your home, but now they're a part of your home-based business. You get to do something special, which is tap into the tax laws that have been created for those who are producers instead of consumers, meaning that those who are business owners versus employees. So you get to play by a different set of rules. So we want to just kind of show you a math breakdown and understand this is just for example purposes only, not exact numbers, not exact scenarios, just example purposes only on how your number one asset is your home-based business. So let's prove it to them.
Yes, and you guys, you got to understand that we are living in a time right now where a job is not enough. If you are only working a job, you know, you can never really truly achieve financial freedom. Jobs were not designed for you to do that. So what we are on a mission to do is show you different ways to make income, explain to you your number one asset so that you can actually retire comfortably opposed to having to work a job until you die. So many people are doing that. Let's show you how to avoid that trap.
Absolutely. Couldn't have said it better myself. Now, number one on the list, like we said, this is about you having tax deductions from having a home-based business, operating that business with the intent to make a profit, meaning you're out there really sharing your product, your service, so you can make money. That's a good look, because one day that business may replace your full-time job. One day you may live fully off of your business and turn it into other businesses. So it's important for you to understand this so you can benefit from the tax laws. Number one, let's say if you have a mortgage, this could be rent as well, and you get a percentage off based on the square footage of your home, based on where you have your office space set up and how you operate your business, depending on what that business is. It may consist of you doing actual meetings at your home or presentations at your home. Depending on the laws and everything in your area, you get to write off a percentage. So in this example, we want to say 20% is able to be written off for a person who has a rental mortgage. 20% of $1,000, which is what they're paying on a monthly basis, equates to $200 a month that they're able to write off on their taxes. $200 a month times 12, giving it a full year of $2,400 in tax deductions based on them having a home-based business using money that they were going to spend anyway. So ask yourself, are you going to pay your rent or mortgage anyway? Absolutely. Nobody wants to be living on the side of the road. So if that's the case, then you might as well figure out a way to make that tax deductible. Number two.
Yeah, let's calculate your utilities, all right? Let's say that you're spending $500. And again, we're going to write off 20% of that, okay? What that does for you is this. Check out these numbers. $100 a month and $1,200 a year. That, you guys, these are tax savings. These are tax write-offs. Think about, once we make it through this entire list, how a home-based business can benefit you. Number three.
The cell phone. And this is what you got to understand. Most people are doing business via their cell phone. Not just talking on it, because it used to be about just the phone conversations. You having phone conversations that were pertaining to business or prospecting or setting up meetings, things of that nature. But people are using their phone literally to prospect via the internet or market their business via social media. We are literally communicating with you through my cell phone as we speak. So we're doing video presentations that will be streamlined on different platforms to build our business, to expand our network, to educate you on the power of a home-based business and how to benefit from it. So guess what? I'm able to write off a huge percentage of my cell phone bill, really 100%, because all we do is business. This just is icing on the cake. So let's imagine a person pays $100 a month on their cell phone bill. That isn't too far-fetched. Many people pay that, less or more. But let's just say a person is doing 85% of business using their cell phone. Well, 85% of $100 is, you guessed it, $85. $85 times 12 for a full year is $1,020. All because you had a home-based business, and instead of you just using your phone to scroll and look down the timeline, you were able to write a portion of that off, even though you were going to pay the cell phone bill anyway. That's the word I want you to lock in. Anyway, absolutely. Let's keep going.
All right, let's talk about mileage, you guys. On average, people are driving about, 10,000 miles, right?
Yep.
Per year. This is what I love about being a business owner. See, a lot of people look at the government like they're after all of our money, right? They want it all. But actually, they show favoritism to business owners. This is what you got to understand. And the mileage changes. But if it's associated with business, the government will literally pay you anywhere from 50 to 56 cents per mile. That's going to a business meeting. That's going to a convention or a training to expand your business, expand your knowledge. That's meeting up with prospects or business partners, okay? Anything that includes you growing your business, calculate those miles, okay? Because they're literally paying you for driving your car. And guess what? You are going to drive your car anyway. Okay, so 56 cents per mile is about $5,600 per year. I just want you to think about that. $5,000 just for driving your car, doing something you are going to do anyway. We're gonna keep stressing the word anyway, and if it's associated with your business. We're not teaching people to do anything illegal or their personal expenses, put those on your taxes. No, if you're a woman in business, if you're a man in business, be in business, okay? Number five.
I love it. All around the clock, be in business. I love how you stress the importance of, look, we're not telling you to finagle any of the tax laws. We want you to abide by the rules.
Exactly.
Now, number five, meals and entertainment. Now, at one point, they tried to take this one away, but then they end up bringing it back because they understood that a lot of times meals are incorporated as it relates to doing business, depending on the events and things that are going on, depending on the type of meeting that you're having. So they brought it on back. And entertainment, it has to be done a certain way. We're not going to get into the details of the particulars on how it has to be done, but just understand that some of the meals, some of the entertainment that you're spending money on can be written off, especially if you're out of town. We're not even going to talk about travel, all of the travel that can be written off as it relates to your airfare, your lodging, and the meals and entertainment associated with it. So let's just say this person spent $200 on meals and entertainment, and they're writing off 50%, because a lot of times when you're doing meals and entertainment, they honor 50%, especially if it's not dealing with travel. So that's a whole nother conversation. So 50% of 200 is $100 per month that they're writing off in meals and entertainment, which equates to $1,200 per year when you multiply it by 12. Let's go to the next one. We all have this one, but hopefully you're using it in a way that can allow you to write it off.
Exactly. Internet. Let's say you're paying about $50 a month. All right. Internet can be 100% tax deductible. Okay, so you get 100% of that, which is $50 a month. A year, you guys, that is $600. Look at all of these tax savings. Now, the government isn't giving you 100% of everything, but they're giving you a portion of it, and rightfully so, okay? So these are just a portion of the deductions. We're going to keep going, and you can also, you guys, verify this information via IRS.gov, okay? Look into the things that you can write off on your taxes legally, ethically, and morally, okay?
I love it. I love it. See, now, I'm going to go over the next two because they go hand in hand. You see, the total deductions, When you tally all of that stuff up, the mortgage, utility, cell phone bill, mileage, meals and entertainment, and the internet, which is mandatory for you operating a business in this day and age, you get a whopping $12,000 and $20. $12,000 and $20 as a grand total that you got to take as it relates to tax deductions. Now, that $12,000 typically isn't dollar for dollar. So, if you understand that you also have to pay state and federal taxes, what they did is lower your state and federal taxes by 30%. And if you do 30% times $12,020, you'll get $3,606. But we're just going to round to the nearest dollars. $3,600 is what you were able to minimize your taxes by. So that's like a net increase in your pocket. So literally, you're able to lower your tax liability by $3,600, and that puts that much more money back into your pocket once you understand it. So if you made $40,000, the government can't tax you fully on the $40,000. Why? Because you had $12,000 plus in tax deductions. So you were able to lower your tax liability. You don't have to know all of that stuff, but if you keep good records, I promise you, all of this is based on record keeping, and you hand it to somebody who understands tax laws, understands the tax advantages of a home-based business, and you allow them to prepare your taxes, trust me, this is elementary to them because they'll understand it. So $3,600 that you're able to lower based on you writing off your taxes. And guess what? If you were in business and you're doing all of these things with the intent to make a profit, it's a good chance you will make some money. So in this example, this person made $2,400 for the year. $2,400 for the year, which is not hard to do. That's basically just $200 a month. So they're just kind of part-timing it. $200 here, $200 there, $200 right here. So they got $2,400 for the entire year. Now, let's do the math. If you look at that $3,600 that they were able to save in taxes, and you add it with that $2,400 that they were able to bring in by operating their business, that's a whopping total of $6,000. Now, this is where it gets interesting, and this is how we prove to you that a business is your number one asset. Right. So your total earned is $6,000. That's that $3,600 plus the $2,400. $6,000 is your total earned. Now, this is what we got to ask you. What are your other options to bring in an extra $6,000 per year? What are your other options? You can do what we're suggesting, which is have a home-based business, minimize your taxes and benefit from those tax laws, make some business income, so now you brought in an extra $6,000 from home. Or you can put your money into some type of investment. And the first investment is how much?
$600,000. Okay, if you invest and getting a 1% rate of return, you would need an investment of $600,000 in order to yield a $6,000 cash return. Correct. Right?
Absolutely. Okay,
so I mean, think about that. You got $600,000 just lying around?
Just laying around somewhere,
okay?
You know.
Okay? I didn't think so. Okay, let's keep going. What about investing and you have a 3% rate of return, okay? That's $200,000. Not a full $600,000, but do you have $200,000 laying around that you can invest today where, you know, somewhere where you're going to yield 3% rate of return just to pay you out the $6,000 a month? Most likely not.
Probably not.
Most people don't, right?
Right.
Okay, well, let's increase the rate of return. Let's say that you're investing and you find somewhere you can put your money and get a 6% rate of return. But the lump sum that you need is $100,000. That's what's going to yield you $6,000 a month. Y'all, I want you to think about it. Most people don't have this laying around when over 60% of America is actually living paycheck to paycheck, okay? It doesn't make sense. But what does make sense is actually opening up a home-based business and just getting that $6,000 flowing back into your household via tax deductions and business income.
Yeah.
One-time investment. Now, let's scratch off that $179.
Scratch it.
Because it's actually way less than that. How about an investment of $50, less than $50, that can yield you that $6,000 rate of return every single month? How about that? No, what is that rate of return? That's not $50 investment. That's not a $6,000 rate of return. That's just a $6,000 that you're actually profiting, that you're gaining in cash flow. But the rate of return is through the roof. Paying $50, less than $40 a month to keep your business going, right? Because businesses aren't free. You can be getting an additional $6,000 in cash flow flowing into your household every year.
Gotta love it. That's about 1,000% rate of return. Right. I don't want to get all mathematical, but that's about 1,000% rate of return that you got just from investing into your own business. So it might cost you, you know, $200 to start a business or $1,000 to start a business, but your number one asset is you operating a home-based business, making a profit, or with the intent to make a profit. Now you're able to write these things off, and now you just skyrocketed your rate of return. What we say is, look, you don't have to even spend $200, $1,000. You can get started in a business that we teach people how to operate from the comforts of their home, that's centered around them bettering their finances, but they get a financial membership, which is a game plan, a roadmap to step-by-step bettering your credit, step-by-step getting out of debt, step-by-step building you an investment plan so you can be on track to retire comfortably and or early. So understanding that, $50 is a no-brainer. Plus, guess what? That goes into your tax deductions as well, because exactly. You get to write that off. So that $50, you write it off, and let's just say you minimize your taxes and made some money, and you can make more than $6,000. Of course, we just want to be modest. And $6,000, now you're able to get a huge rate of return. So let's boil it all down. Your business, as we stated, a home-based business, because this is money you're spending anyway. If it was a brick-and-mortar business, you would have to go lease a location or buy a facility or buy the land and then get into debt so you can own the building that sits on the land. But your home-based business is bills that you already have. What we're saying is convert those bills into business expenses. Don't just look at those bills as just a task. I got to pay these bills. You should look forward to those bills and say, I get to pay these bills. This is a privilege for me to pay these bills. Why? Yes. Because this will lower my tax liability, put more money back into my pocket, and I can take that money and flip it once you understand the rule of 72. But that's in a whole nother video. So your business is your number one asset. And what we're saying is we want you to strategize your way to wealth. A lot of people do all kind of things, jump through hoops. We want you to strategize your way to wealth. Wealth is a strategy. Wealth has to be strategic, and building wealth is a team sport. And we're here to help you and assist you any way that we can. If you can partner with us, then hey, we got your back. We can plug you into everything we've been able to benefit from, or you can give whoever shared this video with you and they can help you along the way as well. But understand, you must be on a team that is centered around building wealth. You got to change your circle if you want your finances to be out of this world. So that's all I got. You got anything else, Coin?
Nothing else, you guys. That's all we got. Mr. and Mrs. Smith
signing out.